President, Secretary General NATO.
I'm so glad to see you.
Good to see you.
Thank you for receiving me.
Well, pleased to have you. Come in. Well, come in. Take your chair over there.
Thank you.
We'll have to small talk for a few minutes while the president's president's running.
Well, how do you feel at the moment?
Fine. Last speech I saw was your speech at the convention. I was in Great Britain and was touring with my wife, holiday. And the BBC broadcasted it.
Well,
I stood up at 1 o'clock in the morning, followed for 4 hours the convention. And you have been in tremendous form, I can say.
That serves above and beyond the call of duty. People here.
Yeah.
Two weeks of press. Welcome.
Well, that's during your time of office, the third Secretary General of NATO. First was Lund.
Yes.
Then Lord Carrington. And now you know this old story? Lord Ismay, the first Secretary General of NATO. When asked what NATO is about, he said, keep the Russians out, the Americans in, and the Germans out. With one exception. That was the first wave.
And this one will be the one that the problem try to answer. They'll have nothing to do with what we're doing.
That's the usual exercise.
Mr. President, what do you think of Secretary Schultz's proposal to cut the staff, the embassy staff in Panama by half, including closing DEA there?
Well, I have to respect his judgment on that. We're concerned right now about some of our people there, and I think that this is just a measure that we're taking and probably temporary.
Is there any concern that if DEA is pulled out of Panama that that could interfere with our drug interdiction program?
No, I don't think we're doing anything that will reduce our ability to intercept drugs.
Thanks,
please.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Jelly beans and beer
stein? Well, both are bad habits.
Which is worse?
Cameras this way, please. NBC. Come on.
Thank you.
It's your favorite. It's the favorite of my wife.
Our most recent television show.
I'd like to begin, if I could, by reaffirming to you America's strong support for the NATO alliance and the defense of Europe. Our commitment to NATO is rock solid and bipartisan. We can't say that about too many things with our political situation, but the vast majority of Americans understand fully the importance of this alliance and of maintaining forces in Europe to guarantee Europe's defense. I've said before, but it's worth repeating, that the history of NATO was a success story. The alliance has preserved peace for 40 years and can do so indefinitely if it remains strong and united. And Americans know that this is in their interest as well as the interest of Europeans. You're taking over the leadership of NATO at a good time, when the alliance is healthy and when prospects are for important progress in East-West relations are opening up. And to take advantage of these opportunities, we must maintain the alliance solidarity and strength which have been key to past successes such as the INF Treaty. And close consultation has shown itself vital to the maintenance of Allied unity, and I've tried during my administration to consult fully within the alliance on all matters which affect our common security. I'll stress the importance of continuing this to my successor, whoever he may be. We must also continue to focus attention on strengthening public support for NATO in both the United States and Europe. Leadership in our countries is starting to pass to younger generations who often do not remember the Cold War and the origins of NATO. And we must assure that they're aware that NATO was a success and there's no substitute for it. And I think we must stress the broad community of values which unites us as free, democratic countries. While the alliance is in excellent shape, I want to stress three issues which I think will command your early attention and about which we do have some concern. The first is a disagreement within NATO over burden sharing. This has the potential in the long run to undermine U.S. support for NATO. There's a growing perception among our people that some allies are not shouldering their fair share of the defense burdens. And the perception isn't helped by the difficulties we're having with Greece and Spain in negotiating renewal of basic rights. We agree that differences on burden sharing should be handled within the alliance context, but we need better European understanding of our concerns and movement to solve the problem. The second issue is nuclear modernization. As long as the United States forces in Europe rely upon nuclear weapons within the context of flexible response, I think we have to insist that these weapons remain up to date. We support development of a comprehensive concept of arms reduction, but this can't substitute for implementing previous decisions to modernize our deterrent. And the third issue is alliance preparation for the conventional stability talks with the Warsaw Pact. I think we need to arrive at consensus on an opening position as soon as possible and work to build support for Western positions among our publics. And there I know you have an important role to play, but I think that's enough for me now. I'd be pleased to hear your views on these issues, and we could perhaps discuss broader East-West relations over lunch.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you. It's given my candidature, and I'm even more grateful.
Like that. That's highly amusing.
There was a formal Marine ceremony, full dress uniform and all. And in that heat, 7 Marines collapsed from the heat. All male. No ladies collapsed.
Our female Marine General just...
Manfred, how are you, sir?
Hey, well, so nice to see you.
Our female Marine General just took command of one of your favorite places, Quantico, to go down and rise.
Mm.
So the lady gentleman, command down there.
That's where I went in
boot camp. Good to see you,
sir. Boot camp.
Mr. President, do you know that we both, the senator and myself, our families, we went down the Colorado on raft.
In the Grand Canyon.
Oh, yeah. You've made that.
Yeah.
I've never made that ride. Gosh.
Oh, you missed something. You missed something. It's really great.
I know.
It's really great. Of course, I was afraid he was not.